Hi everyone! Welcome back to integralcalc.com. Today we're going to be doing another U-Substitution example. This one also includes a definite integral. The integral that we're given is the natural log of x divided by x, and we're going to be evaluating on the limits of integration 1 to e. So the first thing we'll do is decide which of these values in our integral we're going to assign u to. In this case, it's going to be the natural log of x, and that's a dead giveaway. Whenever you see natural log of x or ln of x, that's what you want to pick for u, because you're always looking to assign u to something that becomes much simpler when you take its derivative. In this case, when we take the derivative of natural log of x, we get 1 over x, which is much simpler than the natural log of x. 1 over x, the derivative of ln of x, is also a good candidate because it will likely cancel the x here in our denominator. So let's go ahead and try it. You can always pick something for u, and if it doesn't work out, go ahead and pick another value. In this case, we'll assign it to natural log of x. We'll then take the derivative of u, and we get du. The derivative of natural log of x, or ln of x, is 1 divided by x. And then remember, we always add this dx here because we take the derivative, so we have to have this dx. We also need to solve for dx, so it's hard to forget it because we'll need to solve this equation here for dx. In order to do that, we have to multiply both sides by x to cancel this x here in the denominator. When we do that, we'll get dx equals x times du. And now that we have something for dx here and something for ln of x, we can go ahead and make these two substitutions. So when we do that, we'll plug in u for the natural log of x, so we'll plug in u here in our numerator, and we'll plug in x times du in for dx here. And what that leaves us with is u over x times x du. And of course we lucked out here because we have an x in the numerator and in the denominator, so the two of those will cancel, and what we're left with in our integral is just u times du. So now that it's that simple, we can easily integrate, and then we'll go ahead and evaluate on the range 1 to e. So integrating this, this u here, remember that we add 1 to the exponent. The exponent on this u is 1. It's implied, so we didn't write it, but we have u to the 1 here. So when we add 1 to the exponent, we'll get 1 plus 1, which is 2. So you can see our exponent here is 2. And then we divide our coefficient, which is also an implied 1 that we didn't write, by the new exponent, which we just found out was 2. So we end up with 1 half u squared, and that's our integral. And then we're going to evaluate on 1 to e. Before we do that, we'll have to plug in natural log of x for u. Before we evaluate on these limits, we want to go ahead and plug back in to eliminate u from our equation. So when we do that, we'll get 1 half times ln of x squared, and again, evaluating on the range 1 to e. So now we'll go ahead and plug in 1 and e. Remember that when we're evaluating a definite integral like this, we always plug in our top number first, which is e. So you can see we have 1 half times ln of e squared, and then we always subtract here in the middle, and then always plug in our bottom number second. So minus 1 half times ln of 1 squared. Now when we simplify this, the natural log of e is equal to 1, so we end up with 1 here. The natural log of 1 is equal to 0. So we plug those two in, and for our first term here, 1 squared is 1, so we get 1 half for the first term, and because everything here is multiplied by 0, we'll get 0 for the second term. So 1 half minus 0 obviously gives us our final answer of 1 half, and that is the area under this integral here on the range 1 to e. So I hope that helped you guys, and I'll see you in the next video. Bye!